second. I'm going to introduce the chunks real quick, and then our judges, and then we'll get started with challenge, okay? Our chef on the day, our homegrown chef. A new addition to the family, Stacy. And then we have one of our chefs, due to an emergency in the family, have to drop out tonight, so Omar stepped in.
You go, Omar.
And Omar has another addition to the family that's helping out. Her name is Haley.
Chicken cordon bleu pizza.
kosher dill pickles and a blanket, and cream cheese, and salami. Soup number one is a northern bean and vegetable noodle soup with salami, which makes it interesting. Northern bean and vegetable noodle soup with salami. Somebody got rid of it. Soup number two is being brought out now. Soup number two is Cuban ham and salami soup. And this, I'm told, has a little kick to it. So it's going to be flavorful. Cuban ham and salami soup with just a little kick. Monterey and Jack cheese.
Monterey and Jack cheese.
Southwestern turkey and Monterey and Jack cheese. Show of hands, okay? Okay, so who liked soup number one the best? Soup number one. Okay. Yeah. Okay, how about soup number two?
Yeah.
Hands down. Soup number three. I couldn't believe what you tell me anyway. Okay, good enough. I just wanted to get an idea. I was talking to the judges here a minute ago, and they were giving me their thoughts, and I said, that's kind of interesting. So I just
wanted. What are their thoughts?
And
what are their thoughts?
What are my thoughts? I haven't tasted any of them.
Yeah, what are their thoughts?
I'm gonna be lucky to get something to eat when I get done. I can't tell you what they're saying. If I did that, that would be unfair. But I just wanted an idea of what you were thinking a little bit. Anybody got any idea who's chef number one? Chef number two? Chef number three? Okay. That's a question Leanne usually asks, and it's kind of fun to listen to who's saying what, but I'm not going to tell you yet. As soon as they make the door open, they are. They said they were ready, now they're gone. Okay, entree number one is pepperoni casserole.
What?
Pepperoni casserole. With mozzarella sauce, cottage cheese, black olives, topped with pepperoni slices. So it's a pepperoni casserole. That just sounds like it's sure will be
casserole season.
Is Lesta pita bread? Topped with roasted veggies, salami, and pepperoni. First one is pepperoni casserole. with mozzarella sauce, cottage cheese, black olives, hot with pepperoni slices. Entree number two is Lesta pita bread, topped with roasted veggies, salami, and pepperoni. I'm surprised somebody didn't know there was something else. Okay. First thing I want to do is I want to correct the mistake that I made earlier. I don't often make mistakes, but when I do, it's usually pretty good one.
Yeah.
Stacy has actually won Iron Chef twice before. It's been a couple years ago, but she's won twice before. So she is a certified Iron Chef. I was trying to think between the lines, and I didn't do that. Okay? Now, for the People's Choice Award, we have a decisive winner in the chef number three. So she's now won three. Is that right? Three? I want to make sure I got the number right. Okay, three. Thank you, dear. Okay, Judges Award. Now, the judges kind of look at things a little different than you guys do. Chef number two.
Wow.
Talked to two or three people at different tables, and tonight was a difficult menu to work with from the standpoint of what the secret ingredient was. When the ladies chose the ingredient and told me what it was, I said, "You got to be kidding me." I said, "All we're going to see is sub sandwiches, and that's what everybody's going to think about." Okay, we didn't have any sub sandwiches. One of the tables said, "Yeah, it's a wonder we didn't get Philly cheesesteaks." That actually sounds pretty good. But appreciate y'all's patience tonight. We had to throw Omar into the pit and help out. Also, you know, you've got an amateur up here announcing, so you know that kind of threw a little bit of a monkey wrench into what to do. We do appreciate you coming in. Let me ask one other thing. Do we have any small business owners here besides Kelly? Okay. If you would, just let us know what your small business is. We're a small business ourselves. We like to promote small businesses. So if you would, just tell us what you do. Small business? Next Saturday, we're going to have music here. Okay, and we'll be selling food that night too. But we'll have music here. That's free, isn't it?
It is. There's no cover charge. It's the Rhythm Relics. They're a local country rock oldies band. They do a really good job. They draw a pretty big crowd, and they've actually outgrown a couple other venues. So they're coming here. We're just kind of partnering with them. We're giving them the place for free, but we're going to sell food. They get to play for their friends and have a place big enough and a place that sells food. And so no cover charge. It's going to be 6:30 to 9:30. They're planning on a three-hour set. So it's going to be fun. Yeah, it's going to be a lot of fun. And then we will be open Father's Day as well. We've taken reservations now for that. It'll be family style. It'll be dude food. We're not, you know, it's Father's Day. So
Meatloaf. Yeah, and for those folks in El Centro, that's next Saturday.
Okay, also. You're not doing one in July.
We will not be doing one the first week of July. We will be absent from the premises.
Okay.
Okay.
We can do it ourselves.
Somewhere else. Also, don't forget Father's Day is coming up. We will be open on Father's Day from about 11 until 2. And we will be serving family style. So if you need a place to go, take your dad or have your dad bring you, come on out.